So when we look at systems of equations, we are talking about more than one equation with more than one variable. Now, if we only have two equations, two variables, then the solution to that system is going to be the ordered pair that makes both equations true. So in this video, we are going to be doing the substitution method, and that's where we're going to replace a variable with an equivalent expression. In the past, it's been substitution is replace a variable with its value or a number, but here it's going to be an equivalent expression. So to solve this system of equations by substitution, we're going to replace a variable with an equivalent expression. So if we notice, they both say y equals. So just looking at the top one, it says y equals 5x minus 8. So we can replace y in this equation with 5x minus 8. So here we go, substitution step. We take our equation, we're going to start with the bottom one here, 2x plus 10, and we're going to replace the y with what it's equal to. Well, it says in the top equation, y equals 5x minus 8, so there is our substitution step there. So now we have one equation, one variable, so now we're ready to solve. So here we're going to want x's on the left, so we have x's on both sides here. So let's move, in air quotes, transpose the two x's over. So positive two x's, we're going to subtract two x's to both sides. So here we go, going from left to right, 5x minus 2x, 3x, we still got a minus 8. No more x's on the right-hand side, just the positive 10. Now we have it down to a two-step equation. So we want to go from 3x minus 8 to just x. So we're going to undo the minus 8 with a plus 8 to both sides. So now we have 3x plus no more equals, and then 10 plus 8 is 18. Still need to undo the 3 being multiplied to the x, so we're going to divide both sides by 3. So 3 divided by 3 is 1. X is 1x is there. And then 18 divided by 3 makes 6. So we know the x value for this system is going to be a 6. Next up, got to find the y. So to solve for y, we can use either equation. Now, we do want to identify which one we think would be easier. So the top equation's got a multiply by 5 and then a subtract. The bottom equation is a times by 2 and then add 10. So I think it'd be easier to multiply by 2 and add 10, so we'll use the blue or bottom equation. And then we just take the x and replace it by what x equals. So in this case here, the x value is a 6, so we just switch the x with a 6, and then we do order of operations. So here we go, y equals 2 times 6 is 12. We still have the plus 10 to add, so y equals 12 plus 10 makes 22. So our ordered pair that makes both equations true, 6 for the x, 22 for the y. All right, to use substitution to solve this system here, our substitution step is going to look like this. So we can start with either equation that we want. So we got y equals 4x plus 5. And now for our substitution, remember, we're going to replace the y with what it's equal to. So in this case here, looking at the other equation, it says y equals negative 3x minus 9. So we're going to replace y with negative 3x minus 9. So now we have an equation with one variable, so we're ready to solve. So we do need to identify which side should the variable go on. So generally speaking, we choose the variable with the biggest coefficient. So here we have a 4, here we have a negative 3. Well, 4 is bigger than negative 3, so we're going to be, in air quotes, moving the x's to the right-hand side, to the bigger coefficient there. So we don't want any x's on the left side, so we need to undo this negative 3 x's. We're going to do that with a positive or a plus 3 x's to both sides. So from left to right, we have no more x's on the left, just the negative 9. 4 x's plus 3 x's, that's going to make 7 x's, and then we still have the plus 5 there. Now we have a two-step equation. We're trying to get x by itself here, or isolate the x, so it's being multiplied by 7 and added by 5. So we want to go from 7x plus 5 to just plain old x, undo the plus 5 with a minus 5 to both sides. So here we have negative 9 minus 5 makes negative 14. And then we have the 7x's here, and no more constant terms here. 5 minus 5 is just 7x plus 0. still need to undo the multiply by 7 here with a divide by 7 to both sides. So over here we have a negative divided by a positive. That's going to be a negative. 14 divided by 7 makes 2. And then 7 over 7 is just 1x. There's 1x there. So the x value for this system is going to be a negative 2. Next up, we're going to find the y value. So again, we can choose either equation for finding the y value of the solution. We're just going to identify which one looks easier. So this one's got two negatives in it. This one's got two positives in it. The numbers are about the same. These ones are middle. This has got a small and a big one. So probably just go with the red one there, or the top one. And again, we're going to replace the x with what it's equal to. In this case, it's a negative 2. Then we do order of operations. You can do this using mental arithmetic if you want, or scratch paper also. So here we go. 4 times negative 2 makes a negative 8. We still have the plus 5. And now to find the y value, we're going to subtract 8 from 5. And that's going to be a negative 3. So there's our solution, our ordered pair that makes both equations true. So there's two basic styles when it comes to substitution. One where you have y equals and y equals, and then the other one where you have an x or a y equals there. So this is what those look like for the substitution step there. So a lot of students will just say, oh, hey, so I just make them equal to each other? Well, they are equal, so I guess, yes, you do make them equal to each other. And then here, this y matches here, so the 4x plus 5 is going to go kind of in the middle there. And then solve for the x, and then after you find that, pick an equation and solve for the y.